right, we're having much fun in the studio. Of course, we still continue with the show. Touchline is the show this particular afternoon. Of course, we're discussing matters, sports, especially football, with regards to what is happening. December holiday is approaching, and a lot of people are staging, you know, grassroots football initiatives set to, you know, give back to the society and empower young people who are passionate about football. And one of them is Absalom Ogana is joining us this particular afternoon. Of course, he's not a new face on the show. He's been here before. Good to see you.
Good to see you.
How have
you
been?
Fantastic.
How is Busia?
Meaning we've extended to you. Busia is doing very fine. I'm landed to Leo, Sasa Ivi. I've just landed here to talk about Budalang Youth Sports Academy.
Talent search. How is it, the progress?
We do talent search each and every year. And this time around, we are doing BISA 2021 talent search for under 15.
Yes.
So that we can give these young people a platform to showcase their talents, and they can be able to fulfill their dreams through their talents.
Young people have exhibited a lot of, you know, talents, and their passion for football is on another level, right?
Budalangi has rough diamonds that just require polishing. And if you polish these diamonds, I'm very sure they are going to shine for the rest of their life. They are going to shine for the rest of their humanity.
This initiative has been running for a while.
Yeah, Budalangi Youth Sports Academy.
Like, since you pioneered the initiative, the program?
We started these activities in the year 2013. And I looked at Kenyan context. I looked at Kenyan scenario. And I realized that there is a lot of problems that are facing football. There are numerous challenges that are still predominant in most of our counties and sub-counties around the Budalangi. And this is because the desire and zeal of our young people to conquer and be number one has unfortunately not been matched with opportunities and facilities like no stadiums, even football itself to play.
Yes.
That inhibit these young people to be number one. If you look at Kenyan context, Banawasike,
yes,
thousands and thousands of our young people lose hope and start engaging in the indulging in various activities like drug abuse,
yes,
prostitution, child labor, child marriage, and even child pregnancies. It can therefore not be argued that idleness breeds crime and various malpractices that can only lead to the destruction of an individual and its communities. So we looked at that kind of context, and we decided, me with some likely-minded people like Lord Silas Wereke in Budalangi, Paul Marahemu, the late Paul Ogutinjura, Ted Omieno, decided to come up with the Budalangi Youth Sports Academy in pursuing our passion, in pursuing our zeal to transform the lives of young people, not only in Budalangi, but also in Busia County and sub-counties around in Kenya. And since we started this initiative, Bwana Maxwell, it has brought a new dawn. Thousands of young people, as you speak, they are benefiting from free mentorship program through BISA. They are benefiting from free and exchange visit program between BISA and national and international academies through BISA. They are benefiting from free scholarships through BISA. And since we started this initiative, we believe that we have one main objective. The main objective of Budalangi Youth Sports Academy is to build an arena whereby under the pavilion we put classes. In those classes we'll be teaching both national and international syllabus so that we can give these young people an opportunity to showcase their talents and invite the international clubs to come in Kenya, to come in Budalangi and tap these talents. I'm very sure what our young people are being paid outside Kenya is much more that is being paid with a big club like Gor Mahia here. A player in Gor Mahia who is being paid like mostly it can be 700,000. That is a little money for the sport. We believe football is a major sporting event in the world. This game of football has contributed in enriching so many individuals.
The question will usually boil down to youth.
Yes.
And it's all about youth management and how we can help them get on to the next stage in their sports careers and everything. And the last time when we talked, we were doing a BISA under 15 talent search.
Exactly, the same thing we're doing this year.
And these are children who are likely to be joining high school, or they are finishing primary and they are joining their high school and all that. So
exactly.
how do you fuse them between high school sports and also joining the Academy of Bison?
We do play this talent search in each and every Sunday of the week. Currently, as we speak, young people are now playing the talent search for this Saturday,
yes,
tomorrow Sunday, and on Monday. After that, we now engage our young people in school, whereby we deal directly with the school games masters, whereby they tap the people who can be able to form a team and come to play on Sunday. So we are very much, it's a very much organized academy, whereby we have director for coaching who deals with all coaches, and coaches involves these games masters in each and every school. Then we have the director for referees who tap the young people who can be able to be trained by FKF and FIFA to become referees. And we have director for communication, we have director for vetting, and we have all other stakeholders that make sure that this academy is running during school and after school.
And what else are after the under 15 now?
Under 15, we do have what we call a recruit. We have director for vetting called Madam Phyllis Odaba. The purpose of this director for vetting is to ensure that she recruits the best. These best are the ones that we take them to an exchange visit program between Bison. Just recently, we brought young people from Budalang who were the best player the previous year to more international stadium Kasarani to play with other some academies here in Nairobi, so that we can invite, we invited the other recruiters from outside the world, outside Kenya, to come and tap these talents. And as we speak, we are very fortunate that we are dealing with the first FC Sonthofen in Germany,
yes,
who are doing an exchange visit program and getting us some materials so that we can be able to fulfill our dreams through BISA.
Zoro, you and I understand that Western is a cradle land.
Yes.
Where he comes from, where the former captain for the national team, Harambee Stars, Victor Wanyama, and his brother, McDonald Mariga. In fact, he's built a sports academy at Ekisumu in Busia, which is currently underway, not yet complete. But in the event that it will come to conclusion,
yes,
I think that will be one of the fantastic projects we've ever witnessed in the country. And I think it's a good initiative because during Christmas festivities, a lot of people organize grassroots football tournaments,
mm-hmm,
but once they are done, it's,
yeah,
over.
Hey,
there is no continuity.
Yeah.
That is the problem. Actually, that is one of the main objectives of BISA. We sat around and decided that we must come with a progressive, an initiative that will be sustainable. Because, Bonosoro,
yeah,
if you look around, kind of, especially during this electioneering time, during this campaign time,
yes,
you will see so many tournaments that lack sustainability. So we brought this BISA so that we can be able to save this generation, to be able to be saved from the bad politicians who brought bad tournaments,
yes,
and use our young people like bait to catch votes.
Yeah.
And immediately after elections, they leave these young people in the village while in poverty.
Yeah.
They don't know what to do. They come 5 years later
with the promises
with
again,
the promises again, yeah, with the tournaments of Mafia Nandoleho. That lacks sustainability.
Okay.
Mafia Nandoleho.
Yeah, yeah.
And they leave these young people in the village wandering in poverty.
Yeah.
And yet these young people are smart. They're energetic.
Yes.
They, if they're given an opportunity, they can play better football than even Ronaldo,
yeah,
or Messi or Rooney outside Kenya.
Yeah.
So we are urging these bad leaders,
yeah,
to join us and ensure that we have a proposal in the National Assembly which says that each and every constituency must have a sports academy so that we can be able to tap talents from the grassroots.
Yeah.
I'm not talking about the bottom up, but I'm saying we start from the grassroots.
Yes.
So that these young people can be able to showcase their talents while they're still young.
Yeah.
Football is another industry.
When you look at what is happening in our country today,
mm-hmm,
in football, and you realize that Football Kenya Federation is in problems and everything that is going on, what can you advise them? Because when you look at youth and how youths are being taken care of. I think we can go as back as the 1980s era, where we had the Olympic youth centers, and if you look at the 80s, that is when Kenya churned some of the best footballers that ever graced the Kenyan game. And we qualified, I think, 3 times in that era for the Africa Cup of Nations. It's all because we had a program that was being run from the youth level, going all the way up. And they selected some of the best players then to play for the national team. And you saw how Kenya flourished. When you look at now, you have a youth system. Now you have a youth system that you are running and everything. Yes. What can you advise the current football managers?
Currently, first of all, I want to appreciate what Daktari Amina Mohamed has done to our Football Federation. That disbandment of Football Kenya Federation is a tick.
Yes.
It was a good tick. Yes. Because if you look at Kenyan context, young people are losing hope. Yeah, most thousands of young people were burying their talents.
Yes.
Yeah, they are even thinking that football does not pay, simply because of the top management of the game, which was sleeping, and not only sleeping, but also engaging in corruption.
Yes.
You cannot be the pilot of the football, and you don't have that passion for it. And I want to urge President Uhuru Kenyatta to support what Dr. Amina Mohamed is doing, because without disbandment of FKF and come up with a proper structure, we will be able to propel our football to another level. Kenya will be able will forever be beaten by Uganda 5-0, Rwanda 10-0, Djibouti even that we are beating 10-0 will start beating us, simply because we don't have that people with passion at that top level. I want to urge government to discuss football budget the same way they discuss a health budget, the same way they discuss education budget,
yes,
the same way they discuss any other big budgets like defense.
Yes.
Because if you have proper structure of football or sports from the grassroots, the people will be healthy, simply because others will be watching, then if you're not playing, others will play, and others will be earning from that football. If you get a young person from, example, borderline, and be paid what someone like Drogba was being paid, or be paid the same amount that Mo Salah is being paid, that person can be able to build a road from of 15 kilometers, 10 kilometers for himself.
It will change a village.
It will change a village. The whole community will show, will see that progress.
Yes.
Football will change the lives of community and Kenyans in the way that can be seen by everyone, in the eyes of everyone. That road that he builds, he'll never carry it away. He'll leave it there to be used forever by everyone that will come there. That's just one individual. What about if we get two? Another one builds a hospital, another one builds a market, another one builds. We'll have development all over through sports. I am here to urge each and every leader to think, these young people, to support Amina Mohamed. Because if you don't think about young people at this time, tomorrow they'll turn up to be rogues. They'll be rogues. They'll be rogues not because they want to be rogues, but they'll be rogues because they'll be hungry.
Against this particular room, they're all reading the same script, because he's reiterating the message that was being delivered by Dave Vitale on the show earlier on, that, you know, there is need for people who are at the helm of football management to be passionate about the game and do what's expected of them, rather than, you know, doing what is geared towards them gaining, other than the footballer benefiting.
Yes. Like me, I've been running this Budalang Youth Sports Academy for the last 7-8 years, and I'm not gaining anything. What I only need is that we must have a structured football academy from grassroots level, so that when you have around the star coach, he can be able to visit these academies and tap talent from there.
Yeah.
Not calling people from Gor Mahia who have been called from everywhere, or from FC Leopards, or from Ulinzi, and say that that is now the team that he has named. He should behave like Ryan Fabish.
The late
Ryan Fabish, the way he was behaving from the grassroots level. That's where you go and get the talents. We have CDF money. We have a lot of money that is being used by tournaments that are called Mafia. And don't know on this, yeah, in this country of yours, everywhere you'll find someone being tournament, all over.
So yes, I look at the games that you are having today here. I think at 2 p.m. you are having 11 Brothers versus Ambassador.
Exactly.
And then at 4 p.m. you have Generation versus Dragon,
yes,
that will be played. And then tomorrow also 11 Brothers versus Palma, then Ambassador versus Sisenye. So those are some of the matches that are happening under the BISA under 15 talent search.
Exactly.
Yeah. So how did you come with all these matches that you're having at the moment?
We do annually we advertise for BISA talent search. Then team from we have four branches of BISA in Bunyala Youth Sports Academy. We have BISA North that is found in Bunyala South. We have BISA North, BISA South, BISA West, and BISA Central. All coordinators of these branches, they do have a center for playing. So when these young people come to play during Sunday, they form teams. They say you are many, you are like 100, now you need to form like 4 teams. So these teams, you give them name. That's why you see there's a Dragon, there's a Leeds, there's a 11 Brothers, so that they now start playing in a competitive
format. Yes.
Whereby at the end of the December, we come together as a grand finale. Uh-huh. In this grand finale, we offer them cash prizes, but we don't call them cash prizes because they are still young, so we call them bursaries.
Uh-huh.
Whereby we give them bursaries ranging from 30,000 to 20,000 to 10,000, so that they can be able to remain in school.
Uh-huh.
Then we also give them trophy to motivate them. And the best players that have been selected, those are the people now we carry in the bus and bring them here to Nairobi, the one that we showed the other day.
Yes.
So this is a very great initiative that if it can be supported by everyone, can be supported by all of you, can be supported by every leader on this earth of Kenya, then we will see development in Kenya that can never be seen through the sports.
Have you also been working in partnership with the Kenya Sports Secondary School Association? Because I understand KSSA is also doing a related thing, especially at the grassroots school, playing against each other, and through the same initiative, you know, talents get spotted by, you know, relevant stakeholders, coaches visiting, you know, Mashinani places to get to identify the level of potential.
Exactly.
Do you work in partnership with them?
We do invite all principals of secondary schools across Kenya to come during grand finale. From 23rd of December up to the 30th of December, we have now proper quarterfinals, semifinals, and now the grand finale. This is the time that they come in and start tapping the talents. That's why I said that BISA has given them an opportunity to school for free. So any principal that decided to take our child from BISA must be able to have a covenant with us that this child is going to school for free for the whole of from 1 up to from 4. So we do work with them hand in hand. Actually, the best players that we played the last match that we had before COVID,
yes,
were all from BISA. If you were at Nyeri, that's where the finals were. They're all from BISA. Those are the talents that they showcased at Nyeri. And we believe that if each and every principal who is hearing in at this time and his school performs well in football can be able to come during December 23rd to 30th at Makunda in Budalang, he will get so much rough diamonds that he will go and polish and be able to fulfill their dreams and be able to showcase their talents and be able to make their school shine through their football.
You are talking about support. What kind of support do you want to get from football stakeholders and other people out there?
First and foremost, I want to thank Dr. Amina Mohamed, and I am inviting her to come during these 23rd to 30th football matches. And the most support I want from her as a stakeholder of sports in Kenya, especially in football, I want her to urge our leaders to bring a motion to the parliament to say that we must have a sports academy in each and every constituency. That is one.
Yes.
Two, I want to urge the Dr. Amina Mohamed to, after this caretaker committee, to come up with a committee, to come up with the FKF chair that has a passion at football. And these FKF personnel must be able also to be able to look at the grassroots football, not only upper level football. Third, I want to urge President Uhuru Kenyatta to look at the budget of sports the same way he looks at the budget of health. That is all.
You see, like parents of nowadays, when their kids are getting passionate about sports, especially football, they say football is unreliable. It's not, you know, do not put bread on your table. Has it been like in terms of parents from Budalangi, have they embraced your initiative to let their kids, you know?
When we started, we had so much, politics. Some were saying, oh, maybe we have played this football for long, it has not been able to propel us to another level. But I told them, what you have brought is a different thing. It is not that tournament of Mafia Ndolero. This is a kind of football that will be able to propel this child from 5 years up to the 18 years. And we'll be able to follow him at the same time to see whether he got job or he did not get job.
We also that has also been the main problem, follow-up and continuity.
Follow-up and continuity.
Yes.
Continuity, sustainability, that has been the problem. So we told them, we have brought this initiative so that we can be able to save these young people from those bad habits of bad politicians who have been using them like a bait to catch votes. So we have brought this football, this BISA, so that we can be able also to have a school whereby we'll be bringing academies from outside Kenya and bring us an exchange visit program here that will make us earn a foreign exchange.
Have you thought of working together with Victor Wanyama? Because I think you guys are neighbors. Have you thought of reaching out to him? And he's a good man. His philanthropy is there in public domain too.
Victor Wanyama is a very good man. Actually, he told me if it was not for politics, we could have built that stadium he's building somewhere else in Budalangi. And currently, we are working hand in hand with him so that he can be able to come during 23rd to 30th of this tournament. And he promised us that one thing that he can be able to fulfill in Kenya is to ensure that we have a grassroots academy. And maybe one of them might be BISA. Let us pray very hard.
Yes. Wow. I think it's been a fantastic show this particular afternoon, talking about national football and even grassroots football initiatives that he said to give back to the society and empower young people who are passionate about football. And Absalom Ogana, who is the director of BISA, Budalangi Youth Sports Association Academy, is joining us to give his views with regards to what is expected ahead of December festivity. A lot of initiatives being put in place. And have you found yourself a guest of honor? You know, you can use this opportunity to reach out to David Ali here, and he has a long story. He can come and empower the young people.
David,
Mashinani.
David Ali, wherever you are, whatever you're doing, whatsoever it is, just put in mind that the Budalangi Youth Sports Academy, it has brought a new dawn. It has brought a new initiative in Kenya that will be able to change the lives of young people in the way that will be seen by everyone. And we welcome you. Which camera? That we can use today. Wherever you are, wherever you are, please come between 23rd and 30th of December so that you can see these rough diamonds that needs polishing. Welcome.
Thank you for coming through, Absalom Ogana. Share his thoughts on what he's doing on the ground to empower young people who love football and soccer. Thank you for coming through, and all the best ahead of your initiative.
For young man who is listening to us at this time, maybe they are losing hope. I want to tell you that we are here. We are here as one of you. We are here as your brother and a friend who are ready to work with you in every steps of your life so that you can be able to fulfill your dream through your talent.
On a light note, someone who studied in Seku is called Tom Ucheli. Seku is in Kitui, I think, and
yes.
He understands your background with working at Machakos with Dr. Mutua, and he said that, you know...
I'm not working with Dr. I'm working for Dr. Alfred Mutua.
For Dr. Alfred Mutua, he's asking, ask Absalom whether he has also spread his wings a little bit further to Machakos, which is not well known for football. I don't know what he means.
We are spreading our wings in terms of... Machakos was the first county that built stadium in a record of 4 weeks, not months, 4 weeks, and that stadium...
But the project has since stalled.
It has not stalled. This is a stadium that has been played in by Harambee Stars.
Right now, as you speak, it is conditioned.
It is conditioned. We used it as, during COVID, when the sports were closed, we used it as a COVID-19 camp. At this time, we are now destroying because COVID has gone down, and soon you'll see now teams start playing in the Machakos Kenyatta Stadium. That is the major initiative that Dr. Alfred Mutua has done, and I'm very proud of him.
Thank you for coming through. Of course, we're going to take a short break, then we will be finalizing and winding up our show with the segment, the Fans on the Fan Favorite segment, where we discuss international football with fixtures coming up later today, this particular evening. Pulsating Clash beating Arsenal against Liverpool, and before then, of course, Man United hoping to no bounce back from two consecutive defeats against. Against which team, Osoro? United playing Brighton. See you then. Don't go away. Stay tuned.
White.